You are listening to Down the Road a Piece with Count Dua, and this is show number 22. We're going to start off today with John Schoolboy Porter, Stairway to the Stars. Started the show with John Schoolboy Porter, Stairway to the Stars on the Chance label from 1951. And he was born 1926 in Gary, Indiana, and he played the tenor sax and had his own orchestra. Welcome to Down the Road a Piece with Count Duop, and this is show 22. Together we shall explore and enjoy mostly music that is from 1945 through 1965, mainly Duop, group harmony sounds, with a touch of blues, jazz, pop, gospel, and novelty added to the mix. My name is Jerry Zwecker, also known as Count Duop on the Internet. Enjoy this show as a two-way conversation in our make-believe living room among friends. The way you can contact me is by email, count-duop@juno.com, count-duop@juno.com. I think I'll start off quickly today with Calvin Bowes Jr., born October 1916 in Trinity County, Texas. He was a trumpeter and a bandleader. Heavily influenced by Louis Jordan, he took part in the development of the jump blues style. He also worked with Eddie Vincent, Dinah Washington, Illinois Jacquette. So what we're going to have today is Calvin Bowes, Sophronia B, on the Aladdin label, 1950. And I wouldn't blame you if you wanted to get up and dance.
Look at his thrown you? Have you got a dollar on your head in the state of California? If it's, I'd like to know. I want a little girl to be all mine in the winter time. When the rain starts raining and the snow starts snowing, you reach up, turn on your radio. Look out, Jack, you better take it slow, cause the chicks are raring to go. Well, you reach under bed, grab a jug, take a little nip, get ready to mug. Look at your gal, you kiss her and you send her, make a holler, I surrender, I surrender! That's a muggin', shoot the liquor to me, John boy. Take a tip from me, she's sweet as my sofronia bee.
That was Calvin Bowes, Sophronia Bee, on the Aladdin label from 1950. I'm going to give you a chance to relax a little bit with Savannah Churchill and the Striders. Her real name is Savannah Valentine Roberts, and she was born in Colfax, Louisiana, 1915. And what we have here is Savannah Churchill and the Striders, I Don't Believe in Tomorrow, on the RCA label from 1951.
I don't believe in tomorrow. I want you to love me tonight. Our dreams may vanish tomorrow, like stars in the dawn's early light. This heart of mine keeps saying, darling, don't delay. Tomorrow is at least 100 years away. I don't believe in tomorrow. I want you to love me tonight.
I don't believe.
Love me tonight.
My dreams may vanish tomorrow,
like stars in the dawn's early light. This heart of mine keeps saying, darling, don't delay. Tomorrow is at least 100 years away. Don't want to wait till tomorrow. Be mine while the moment is right. I want you to love me.
Great Savannah Churchill and the Striders backing her up. I Don't Believe in Tomorrow on the RCA label from 1951. And I liked that song so much, I had Sonny Till and the Orioles do that in the recording studio. Now we got a very fine sound by the Imperials, also known as the Gaylords, and the Ambassadors on Timely. They were from Newark, New Jersey, and the group consisted of George Copes, Rudy Copes, James Morris, Earl Thomas, and Louis Van Dyke. And what we have right now is the Imperials, You Should Have Told Me, on the Savoy label from October 1953. And this is the flip side of My Darling that we played on a previous show.
You should have told me that you were in love with me, that you really cared for me. Then I would have known you should have made that what you were saying. Not a game you were playing, then I would have known. But maybe it's not too late, oh, for me to say I love you. And things could have been different, my dear, if I had only known you should have told me that you were in love, with me. That you really cared for me. Then I would have known.
Now I'm going to give you the Shepherds. Slightly different style. They were formed 1959 in Chicago. They created a transitional style between R&B and soul. A couple of the guys in the group were originally with the Palms on United and the Bel Airs on Decca. The group was named for the producer Bill Bunky Shepherd, and the group consists of Millard Edwards, the lead and bass, Murray Eskridge, Jimmy Allen, James Dennis Isaac, O.C. Perkins, and Kermit Chandler on guitar. And what we're going to hear now is The Shepherds, Queen of Hearts, on the Constellation LP from 1964.
Well, now our love is still no, you're not with me. My heart is still with you, my
darling. Oh, if you find
so darling,
I love to be untrue, then there's nothing more.
So darling,
I can't ask of you, so I'll
dry my eyes, turn my back, walk away.
The Shepherds, Queen of Hearts on Constellation LP from 1964. Now I want to play an old favorite of mine by George Hamilton IV. He was born in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, July 1937, and the song is George Hamilton IV, Why Don't They Understand? On ABC Paramount from 1957.
Why lead us by the hand? Why don't they understand? Why do they smile and say, love can't be ours today? Why don't they understand? Can it be wrong caring for you the way I do? It can't be wrong sharing with you the warmth, the love of love, belonging, and soon we'll wander hand in hand into love's wonderland. Then they will understand. Of love, belonging, and soon we'll wander hand in hand into love's wonderland. Then they will understand. Then they will understand. Then they will understand.
George Hamilton IV, Why Don't They Understand? On ABC Paramount from 1957. Let's pick up the pace with a little rock and roll. We have Larry Chance and the Earls. He was born 1940, born Larry Figueredo in Philadelphia, and he moved to the Bronx and became a doo-wop legend. And the group composed of Larry Chance, the lead, Bob Dylan, Eddie Harder, Larry Palumbo, and John Ray. What I want to play for you right now is Larry Chance and the Earls, Cross My Heart, on the Rome label, 1961.
Cross my heart, darling, I love you. I wish I took a sets my soul afire. For you're my heart's desire.
Chance and the Earls, Cross My Heart on the Rome label from 1961. What do you say we rock a while with Big Joe Turner? His real name, Joseph Vernon Turner. He was born May 1911 in Kansas City, Missouri. They called him the Boss of the Blues. I would call him one of the all-time great blues shouters. He also became known as the Singing Barman. Also was part of the transition from jump blues to rock and roll. His husky, booming voice was needed in the saloons in those days. They didn't have amplification. And what I have for you now is Big Joe Turner, Moody Baby, on the MGM label, 1949.
She's mean as she can be. I got a real moody baby. Yeah, she's mean as she can be. She's got a million tricks, and she tries them all on me. She's a real loving woman, wears a smile like she wears a hair. She's a real loving woman, wears a smile like she wears a hat. But when she's in a bad mood, I can't find that girl anywhere. She the loving one. And when it's time to go to bed and we turn out all the lights, I think she's ready for some loving. That chicken ready to fight. Yeah, she's my moody baby. Yeah, she's mean as she can be. one day that chick might poison me.
Big Joe Turner, Moody Baby, on the MGM label from 1949. Let's invite the Four Tunes into our living room. They're considered a pop group. They're originally the Sentimentalists backing Savannah Churchill. The group consists of Pat Best, Jimmy Gordon, Jimmy Nabby, and Danny Owens. And what we're going to hear today is the Four Tunes, How Can You Say That I Don't Care, on RCA label, 1950.
How can you say that I don't care when you know what you mean to me? How can you say that this love affair was never meant to be? Each night I pray that you'll come back someday, but what good does it do? How can you say that I don't care when you know darn well I do?
Each night I pray, baby, you'll come back someday,
but what good would it do?
Would it do?
Darling, if I can't have you, how can you say that I don't care when you know
cha-cha-da,
darn well
cha-cha-da,
I do?
Cha-cha-da-doo, cha-cha.
Pat Best and the Four Tunes, How Can You Say That I Don't Care, on RCA from 1950. In the second half of our show, we have a feature of two groups from Massachusetts coming up. First is Margot Sylvia and the Tune Weavers, and the G-Clefs. Now we're going to hear from Joe Liggins. His original name is Theodro Elliott. He was born in Seminole, Oklahoma, 1916, and changed his name to Joseph Christopher Jr. for the stepfather. Joe's band would play R&B, jazz, blues, and shuffle boogie. What we're going to hear now is Joe Liggins' Freight Train Blues, on the specialty label from 1953.
Listen to the rhythm, the clitter clatter, the clang banging rhythm, the titter patter. Hear the lonesome whistle, the train is roaring, roaring across the trestle. Listen to the rhythm, rhythm of the freight train. I've been to Kansas City, the weather's pretty. I'm on my way to Dixie to see my baby. I've been to Arizona, the sun is shining. I'm going to California to drink some wine, then going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Ooh-wee, ooh-wee.
North Dakota. Got no time to lose.
Joe Liggins, Freight Train Blues on the Specialty label from 1953. Here is the first record of our Massachusetts special, The Toon Weavers. They were formed in 1957 in Woburn, Massachusetts. Now, the group consists of Margot Sylvia, born Margot Lopez, April 1936, and Gilbert J. Gil Lopez. And Margot and Gilbert were brother and sister, John Sylvia and Charlotte Davis. And what we're going to hear now is Margot Sylvia and the Toon Weavers. My Congratulations Baby on the Casa Grande label from 1960.
Congratulations, congratulations. Ooh, my congratulations, baby.
Sylvia and the Toon Weavers, My Congratulations Baby on the Casa Grande label, 1960. And I saw them live in person at the United in Group Harmony meeting around 1989 in New Jersey, and they were great. The second record in our Massachusetts set is the G-Clefs. They consisted of four brothers and a fifth member from Roxbury, Massachusetts. The members of the group are Teddy Scott, Chris Scott, Tim Scott, Langa Scott, and Ray Gibson, childhood friends, and Ira Queller, the keyboard man. What we're going to hear now is the G-Clefs, Lover in the Morning, on the Paris label, 1957.
A lover in the morning and a lover in the nighttime. A lover in the morning and a lover in the nighttime.
Now she looks at me, and I can see she's meant for me.
Lover in the morning and a lover in the night.
I love her, oh how I love her, oh so much. Oh gee, I sure can see
morning and a lover in the nighttime.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our Massachusetts record set. It was G. Clef's Lover in the Morning on the Paris label from 1957. Now I'm going to put on one of my favorite groups, the Royals, all from East Side of Detroit. The lead, Charles Sutton. And you got Henry Booth, Lawson Smith, Sonny Woods, and John Kendricks, better known as Hank Ballard. And what we have today is Charles Sutton and the Royals, A Love in My Heart, on the Federal label from 1952. And around the year 2000, I saw Charles Sutton at the United Group Harmony Association in New Jersey, and it was fun to meet him.
I've missed you so.
Charles Sutton and the Royals, A Love in My Heart, on the Federal label from 1952. The Queen of the Blues is ready to sing for you. Dinah Washington. She was born Ruth Lee Jones, and she was born August 1924 in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. She was raised in Chicago, and she's known for absolute clarity and bluesy phrasing. And what we have today is Dinah Washington, Caravan, on the Mercury label from 1961.
Light and stars above that shine so bright, the mystery of their fading light that shines upon our caravan. Sleep upon my shoulder as we creep across the sand so I may keep the memory of our caravan. Desert caravan. Within our desert caravan, caravan, caravan.
That was Dinah Washington, Caravan, on the Mercury label from 1961. I would like to slow it down with one of the greatest groups of them all, the Ravens. Today we shall hear from a later group of Ravens. This group consisted of Jimmy Stewart, Joe Van Lone, Louis Fraser, and Jimmy Ricks, the bass. What we're going to hear is Jimmy Ricks and the Ravens, Going Home, on the Mercury label from February 1954.
Going home, going home, I'm a going home, quiet like some still day, I'm just going home. It's not far, just close by, through an open door. Work all done, care laid by, gone to fear no more. Mother's there, expecting me, father's waiting too.
far, just close by. I'm a going home.
That was some ending. Jimmy Ricks and the Ravens, Going Home on the Mercury label from February 1954. The high voice in the ending was Joe Van Lone. Are you in the mood for some blues? Well, I have the Five C's for you from Gary, Indiana, and they live crosstown from the Spaniels, and the group consisted of Curtis Nettles, Clarence Anderson, Melvin Carr, and Tolerant Notes. So what we got is the Five C's, Tell Me, on the United label, 1953. Curtis Nettles and the Five C's, Tell Me, on the United label from 1953. And Mitch Rosowski's book was very helpful on that group. Now I'd like to pick up the pace a little bit with the five discs. They were from Bedford-Stuyvesant, Brooklyn. And the group at that time was Mario DeAndrade, the lead, Paul Albano, Tony Basile, and Joe Bracco. And Andrew Jackson, the bass. And what I have for you is the five discs, My Chinese Girl, on the Duane label from 1959.
She bowed
Nice bit of rock and roll. That was Mario DeAndrade. And the five discs, My Chinese Girl on the Duane label from 1959. Now I'd like to play a record by Little Eva. Her real name is Narcissus Boyd. She was born June 1943. She was the babysitter for the songwriting team, Carol King and Jerry Goffin. And what I'm going to play now is Little Eva, Run to Her on the Dimension label from 1962.
Darling, don't you know I want the best thing for you? But if the best thing for you isn't me, I'll understand. If you found another girl who satisfies you more than I do, run to her. I'll step aside. If you think her lips can kiss you better than my lips can kiss you, run to her. Forget about my pride. If someone else's arms can hold you better than my arms can hold you, go to her and show to her all your devotion. If somebody else can make you happier than I can make you, run to her.
Little Eva, Run to Her on the Dimension label from 1962, and that was a little takeoff she did on Bobby V's Run to Him. Now we're going to rock a while with Big Joe Turner, the boss of the blues, featuring his transition to rock and roll. Doc Pomus, the songwriter, said rock and roll would have never happened without him. So now you're going to hear Big Joe Turner, Love Roller Coaster on Atlantic from 1957.
I got a comedy power going 1,000 miles an hour. We, oh, I got a fever about 110. My head's spinning around like a top, up and down, all around. Oh, you, bebop, don't stop till I get on the 4th of July. Bebop, thank you, ma'am. You really got me reading. I ain't telling no lie. Right on. Never coming down to earth. I'm gonna stay up high long as I'm up here with you. I'm gonna stay up high, long you're up here
Big Joe Turner, Love Roller Coaster on Atlantic from 1957. Well, that's all the time we have today. I hope you enjoyed this show, show 22, and we can do this again real soon. You can contact me at count-doop@juno.com, count-doop@juno.com. This is Jerry Zwecker. Until next time.